Good morning. This is Lou Vanderwig, pastor of the Goodland United Methodist Church. Thank you for joining me in this Christian devotion for Tuesday, March the 10th, 2015, as part of the Good Neighbor Hour. In Jesus' Sermon on the Mount in Matthew 5, verses 13 through 16, he says, "You are the salt of the earth. But if salt has lost its taste, how can its saltiness be restored? It is no longer good for anything, but is thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city built on a hill cannot be hid. No one, after lighting a lamp, puts it under a bushel basket, but on the lampstand, and it gives light to all in the house. In the same way, let your light shine before others, so that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father in heaven." In this teaching, Jesus is talking about remaining vital and active in our faith. The Epistle of James in chapter 1, verses 22 through 27, is an admonition to Christians based on this teaching, as it says, "But be doers of the word, and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. For if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror, for they look at themselves and, on going away, immediately forget what they looked like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. If any think they are religious, do not bridle their tongues, but deceive their hearts, their religion is worthless. Religion that is pure and undefiled before God the Father is this, to care for orphans and widows in their distress, and to keep oneself unstained by the world." You've heard the old cliche, "You are what you eat." It is also true that we are what we do. We would sometimes like to believe that we are what we say we are, but sometimes our actions do not tangibly support who we say we are. This is hypocrisy, and it is something Christians are accused of on a regular basis. Truth is, it is much easier to talk the talk than it is to walk the walk. Being spiritually fit is somewhat like being physically fit. I have an excellent physical exercise program that I think about a great deal and I talk about often. It is a program that would help me to be much healthier than I am, and it would be an excellent example for others to follow. I tried it once for a short time and it worked. Problem is, I tend to talk more about doing it than I spend time doing it. Talking about it has little positive effect. I hate to admit it, but sometimes the way I exercise my faith falls to the same complacency. That too has little positive effect in my life or the lives of others. That well-known Afro-American spiritual based on Jesus' teaching in Matthew 5:14 through 16 issues a call to all Christians. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. There, I've said the words. Now what will those words look like as we live life together? Let us pray. Heavenly Father, by the power of your Holy Spirit, help us to be doers of the word and not merely hearers who deceive ourselves. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. On behalf of the Goodland United Methodist Church, this is Pastor Lou Vanderwig wishing you a good day filled with the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ.